Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. In this video, we're going to share with you how to heal your acne. I wish I would have known this when I was going through high school. I had really bad skin, so I'm going to share with you what to do. There's several factors that will affect the skin, but primarily we're going to talk about the anatomy of something called a sebaceous gland. What is a sebaceous gland? It's a little gland in your skin. You have it in your hair. You have them all over the place. But you don't have them over the soles of your feet in different places. But basically, if this gland is malfunctioning, you will have acne, blackheads, whiteheads, oily skin, dry skin. You can have any combination. And so let's start with the vitamin A. If your vitamin A is low, you're going to have problems with this gland. Vitamin A controls and regulates this gland in your skin. So without vitamin A, your skin can be really, really bad. There's a couple factors you need to know, though, about what happens at the cellular level. Vitamin A can kill unfriendly bacteria in your skin. And so one of the myths that people have is that they think they have to just scrub out these blackheads and whiteheads and scrub their face and sterilize their face. That's going to damage your skin. That's what I used to do. And it was incorrect because you have a layer of friendly bacteria on your skin that's supposed to be there to protect you. When you scrub too hard, you can destroy that. Also, when you take antibiotics, you will destroy it as well. So I know people take antibiotics and their skin gets better, but if you can just keep your good bacteria in your gut healthy, you don't have to go that route. There's even a condition, drug called Accutane, which is a high level of synthetic vitamin A, which is really good for the skin, but it has a lot of side effects. So anytime you take a vitamin in high potencies, it comes with a package. There's a lot of problems. We don't want to do that. We want to take vitamin A typically in its natural form, not synthetic. Okay, I'll show you what to do. But vitamin A can control the bacterial growth, controls the oil coming out of the skin, the dryness, and actually it can get rid of acne. Vitamin A foods, people think of carrots, spinach, kale, anything orange or yellow, that's true. But those vitamins in the vegetable family are pre-vitamin A factors. They're not active forms. So your body has to convert the pre-vitamin A to the active form. And it's very difficult for your body to do that in many cases. If you're lucky, you might convert 4 to 5%. So you're really not getting your vitamin A source from the vegetable, you're getting it from the animal products that you eat. And that's why a vegetarian has a lot of dry skin, they have vitamin A deficiencies, which is dry eyes, can't see at night, sinus problems, things like that. So the best source of vitamin A that I would recommend, a natural source, would be cod liver oil, but not just any cod liver oil. You want to get a cod liver oil that is virgin cod liver oil, because when you get traditional inexpensive, cheap cod liver oil, you're basically getting a lot of problems. You're getting added vitamins, you're getting a heated product that kills off all the good nutrition. It's refined. It might have too much of one thing versus the other. I don't like it. So there's a lot of problems with just real cheap cod liver oil. I would get a high quality virgin cod liver oil. And also, as a side note, you probably have heard about the fermented cod liver oil, right? Now, I used to buy into that, but as I was studying it, I realized you can't ferment cod liver oil. You can't ferment an oil, only a carbohydrate. So basically, it's bogus. And when I bought the stuff, it tastes very, very fishy, because it's when you try to ferment it, you're going to cause a rancidity or a souring effect, and it's going to go rancid. So the cod liver oil, if it's fresh, shouldn't have a bad smell. But that's a really good source of not just vitamin A, but vitamin D as well, which we'll get to. Also, liver. Personally, I don't like eating liver, but I just want to let you know that liver has a lot of vitamin A. But of course, if you're going to do liver, do grass-fed, organic, don't do just regular liver. And then the other thing is butter. Kerrygold butter is a really good source of grass-fed butter, and it's loaded with vitamin A. That would be a good source of vitamin A. And egg yolks, pasture raised egg yolks. That's what I would recommend. I have a lot of those. That's really loaded with vitamin A. So vitamin A is very important. and regulating the sebaceous gland, and that's the first thing you need to do. I don't recommend doing massively high potency, just fractionated vitamin A pills, because there's a toxicity problem with that. You're going to create deficiencies in other things, okay? You have to really know what you're doing. Now, next thing is low vitamin D. Vitamin D is not just for your bones. It's not just for your mood. It's for your skin. And guess where you get this? From the sun. And guess you also can get it from the cod liver oil. So cod liver oil has a nice balance of vitamin D and vitamin A. But sun, and despite what you've been taught about sun is actually very, very healthy for the skin, and it doesn't cause skin cancer. No, in fact, sun actually protects you against a lot of types of skin cancer and other cancers because the vitamin D actually is good for the immune system. Now, I'm not saying lay out in the sun and get completely leathered and like burnt, things like that. I'm just talking about a little bit of sun is really good for the skin. So these two are really important. And all the fat-soluble vitamins, vitamin A, D, E, K, there's something unique about them. They have the ability to be stored in fat, and also they have the ability to go through the fat layer of the cell and into the center of the cell where the DNA is, and they can affect the DNA of the cell and control your genes. And that's why if you're deficient in these fat-soluble vitamins, you can have a lot of structural problems with your proteins, your body tissues, okay? So that's a little bit different than the other water-soluble vitamins like vitamin B, things like that. So vitamin D, vitamin A, very important. Gallbladder, I want to mention that because if a person has a congested gallbladder or a congested liver or a bad liver or no gallbladder, what's going to happen is that you're not going to have enough bile, B-I-L-E. Bile is a fluid that kind of helps you break down fats and fat-soluble vitamins. So if you're consuming these and your skin is not getting better, it could be that you just don't have enough support from the gallbladder to absorb them into the body. So it's just something I always look at when someone's taking these things because you need to be able to not just get it, but absorb it. Okay, next thing, androgens. What is an androgen? An androgen is a hormone produced by your stress gland, your adrenal glands on top of your kidney, but it's also produced by the ovary, okay, and the testicle. But mainly this in a female is coming out of the ovary, and during that time of the month, they might have a little acne because they have a little too much androgen versus estrogen. So if that happens, they'll get acne. I have videos on how to deal with that. But guess what triggers androgens? Sugar. Yeah, too much sugar. So if you were to have a problem with androgens or other conditions called polycystic ovarian syndrome, if you don't know what that is, that's fine. But if you have it, you know what I'm talking about. The best solution for that is to get the sugar down to zero in your diet, okay? And that will help you greatly. So there's two things that will increase androgens. One is sugar, and the other thing is stress, okay? So sugar and stress really affect your skin. Then we have vitamin B5. What is B5? Pantothenic acid. Pantothenic acid is a vitamin that gives you nice, clear skin. The problem is people take it synthetically or they take too much of it individually, and then they create deficiencies in other things like biotin and their hair starts getting brittle. So again, I'm not saying go out there and start taking massive dosages. Just realize that vitamin B5 does control the skin, and you just need to look at what depletes vitamin B5, and that would be stress. So again, stress is a factor that we want to start to deal with and lower that to help your skin. The other thing is insulin. Insulin is a hormone that regulates blood sugars, and insulin is triggered by sugar. So, and that's also in the hidden sugars, like breads, pasta, cereal, crackers, biscuits, waffles, pancakes, muffins, sodas, juice, alcohol. All that will influence this gland right here. Now, these are really comprehensive things, but if you have acne, you need things that you can do to better your skin and not be stuck in a situation where you're taking Accutane or some antibiotics. So you want to be able to look at all these to see maybe what's missing in your diet. If you're a junk food junkie like I was, then you need to start consuming these foods and get the sugar out of the diet. Your skin will clear up nicely. The other thing that I'm going to recommend is that even though vegetables don't have the active form of vitamin A, you're going to have to eat a large quantities to get all the other nutrients, the minerals, the other vitamins that make these work, and then clean out your liver, because you can't just, you know, live on olive oil, you know. So I highly recommend you eat the vegetables as well. The combination of that with some of these things, cutting the sugar out, trying to avoid the stress as much as possible, that can greatly improve your skin. So go ahead and do these things and then write your comments below.